Hello, hello. Good Thursday evening, afternoon, day to you. I hope you're doing well. I want to, as I titled this video, talk a little bit about You Cannot Cheat the Grind. And this is going to be a video from my heart and some experiences that I'm currently going through and how I actually know you can't cheat the grind. And then other insights to your path when your journey takes a different turn on this path. So there's 3 points that I want to go over with you today. The first one is planning consistency, why that's so important. The second one is using your past as a university. And then the third one is giving yourself grace. So why this topic, why this issue of you can't cheat the grind? Because I am walking on that path myself now currently, and that's kind of redundant, but whatever. And so I wanted to just share kind of this insight that I've had in terms of using your past as a university. I talk about that occasionally. And the one thing that I'm happy to share, hey Michael, the one thing that I'm happy to share is that, Ashley, good afternoon, is that I actually have been on this journey and I've noticed that I've recently gained some weight. I'm gonna guess it's been about 20 pounds and I really have largely avoided the scale, but I know it's about 20 pounds. And the one thing that I feel so excited about with this weight gain is that I don't hate myself. There have been so many times that I have gained weight and I have felt like such a loser. Just like, oh my God, how could I let that happen? Or I'm so dumb, or I'm so stupid. Just all the stuff that I tell you guys not to tell yourself, all the bad language. Historically, that is what I've told myself. And in particular, I felt like a failure. But I noticed that this time I was kind of like, huh, look at that. Gained some weight. What's up with that? And it just is a fact. It doesn't mean that I'm a bad person. It doesn't mean that I am stupid. It doesn't mean that I am a failure. It just means I gained some weight and that's it. And so that's the point about using your past as a university, that okay, I've done this before. I've lost weight, I've gained weight, I've lost weight, then you know, the whole yo-yo dieting thing. But what is different this time is that I have been studying emotional eating and the impact that that has on our psyche, and also planning and consistency and how that comes into play. And notice that these additional pounds have been largely due to I stopped planning. I was being inconsistent, you know, dabbling a little bit here, eating a few things that I thought were healthy, like, you know, my Greek yogurt, eating almonds, eating cashews, eating, right, just doing little things along the way that I thought were healthy, but really were not. Hey, Melanie, how are you, sweet friend? And so what I'm learning is that there are some reasons that I was going for the yogurt, even though it was a healthier food. There's some reasons I was going for the cashews or the peanuts. Rarely did I want any almonds because they're just, you know, that's just healthy. But I thought I was getting some healthy food. So this part about using your past as a university, one of the points that I wanted to make, and also really kind of digging into what was the emotion that I was feeling when I was eating the can of cashews on the way home from the store. You know, it's a 30-minute drive from the store sometimes. So why was I eating them? What was I doing? So what do I have to do? So for me, this is what I mean about when I give you guys suggestions about writing down what is going on when you're having that emotional eat so that you can actually drill down and figure out a way in order to solve it. So for me, it was largely boredom. It's like, okay, it's boring just driving down that. And so it's mindless eating, right? You just open. And I also recognized that I was hungry. So, okay, we all know that from the beginning of day one, right? Don't go to the grocery store hungry. But the point is, what kinds of things can you put into place in order to get you over those humps? When you so that's why you want to recognize that you're having an emotional eat. What is the emotional eat that's going on? And what are the circumstances so that you can start putting things in place? So for me, it was eating in the car. As you guys know, I spend a lot of time in the car. I've put that 20,000 miles on my car in, let's see, I got in my car, no, not Christmas, Halloween. So November, December, January, February, 4 months, 20,000 miles. That's like, how about a bag of Hershey Kisses? Yes, girl, those Hershey Kisses, those little miniature Reese's, whatever your thing is, it's the same thing. So I thought I was doing something healthy by binging on the cashews, but really the emotion is the same and looking for a better for me behavior. So with all the driving that I'm doing, and then I noticed that I was eating in the car, or, you know, and then it, there really is something to the fact that if you're not focused on what you're eating, you're doing all these other things, you kind of don't really feel hungry. You don't really feel full. You still kind of have this sense of hunger. So I have put in this temporary rule of I don't get to eat in the car. I mean, I can eat while I'm sitting in the car and stationary, but not this kind of mindless eating that I was doing because that was causing me a lot of problems. So again, I'm using this as an example to say to you, hey, this works. Give yourself some grace while you're on your path and know what works for you and what doesn't work for you. If you are like me, you know, Melanie, you with the Hershey Kisses, or me with the cashews, you know, used to be the little Reese's miniatures. Why? What is going on? And let's own what is happening at that moment so that we can start training ourselves to recognize, oh, wait a minute. Okay, I got this. I don't want this result, because how do you feel after you eat a bag of Reese's? Not good. I didn't even feel good after I ate a can of cashews, but I was still doing it. So we're done with all that. I did actually switch to pistachios. So we're making progress. First it was peanuts, then it was cashews, and you know, and now we're into the pistachios. But the point is recognizing what's going on, identifying it, writing it down, bringing your brain into focus that what those behaviors that you're doing are not serving you, because you're going to look up and you're going to end up, you know, 20 pounds extra weight like I'm doing right now. So I also know that I'm going through a particular time in my life where I have a lot of things going on. So if I'm not laser focused on my strategy, on being consistent and on planning, and I'm letting my prefrontal cortex decide, okay, I got to get something to eat right away, then that's not serving me well. So I'm just like super stoked actually about these 20 extra pounds. Which nut is the healthiest? So pistachios are really the healthiest, certainly of all those. So peanuts, no. Cashews, also high fat. So then pistachios is going to be the best one. So they're low fat, still have some nutrients in them. Almonds are really ultimately the best. But pistachios and almonds are about in that same vein. Hey James, progress, not perfection. Yes, girl. Yes, yes, yes. Hey Annette, good to see you, sir. Hope I see you next week. So that's kind of really what I'm working towards, and I'm encouraging you to work towards, and we can work towards this together. So a couple things. Give yourself grace. Stop with the negative talk. And I'm excited about these extra 20 pounds. I feel a little embarrassed. I'm like, but you know what? Not really that much. You know, I don't feel like the failure anymore. So that's the grace part. Learning from your past, saying, hey, well, how did I get here? And what is the way out? So that's what we want to start working on. So let me just double check my notes and see if I've covered all of the topics. Planning and consistency. I touched on that a little bit. So it's the planning thing. So even though I travel a lot, I keep a cooler in the back of my truck. So planning, what can I do? What can I put in that cooler? I always keep ice in there because I love ice water. And so what is happening in your life so that you can plan? So particularly if, to the extent, maybe you just want to plan a day in advance and say, all right, tomorrow I'm going to eat these things. So this is a strategy that I learned when I was in Overeaters Anonymous. This is what I'm going to eat tomorrow, and eat that, only that. Because you have now planned it, you have given some thought to it, and you're not making a decision in the moment. You're not sleepy, you're not tired, you're not just going for that quick fix. But if you can plan and be consistent with that planning, then that's gonna allow you, and you've gotta stick to it. You gotta say, all right, tomorrow for breakfast, hey Sue, tomorrow for breakfast, I'm having such and such. I'm having this for lunch, I'm having that for dinner, and stick to it. Now, am I saying never have any of the Hershey Kisses? No, I'm not saying that. What I am saying is, if you didn't plan for that, then no, don't have it. And how does that help you? That's going to help you because it's going to take, again, that decision away from your prefrontal cortex and put it into actually your human brain. You are going to be in control of your thoughts and your actions. And you know that's going to help you with not making a decision in the moment that doesn't serve your broader goal. All right, so the second point was using our past as a university. I'm going to be wrapping up here in just a moment. And so the past is a university. So for me, that example is all the times that I've yo-yoed in the past, all the times that I've just gone here, you know, up and down, up and down. I've tried this, I've tried that. What works, what doesn't work? It's like, okay, what have I learned from that? What I've learned from that is I was pretty hard on myself, and I expected perfection. And I'm like, I'm over that, right? So let's see. Sanji mentioned that earlier. Progress, not perfection, 100%. So I've learned not to expect perfection, but I've also learned, hey, listen, I gotta have some things in place. I work this way. These things serve me better. Yogurt doesn't really serve me. I thought it was better for me than ice cream. It is, but it still causes me to be bloated and inflamed, and I still tend to eat too much of it. So that's using your past as a university. Hey, nice try, Lauren, going with the yogurt, but yeah, no, not so much. You're still not really dealing with the emotion, which I mentioned actually in a live a while ago. But anyway, the third point on today's video, I just want to wrap this up again, is giving yourself grace. And so what I mean by that is, hey, I don't feel like a failure this time with these extra 20 pounds. I don't feel like a loser. I don't feel like, because it's so easy, right? It's like, oh, well, she's a health coach. She didn't gain all that weight. Who she thinks she is? Y'all, I'm human and I'm okay with that. But in the past, I wouldn't have been okay with it. But it's very liberating to own that this is a journey. It's very liberating to know that I have been doing the work along the way this time to recognize what are my triggers, what are my downfalls, what are the emotions that I'm still eating and why. And when I crave a certain thing, when I have an urge for a certain thing, it's like, okay, time out. What's really going on? I'm actually happy to say that I'm over the whole milkshake thing. So that's really awesome. If you fall down, get up. Yes, girl. Yes, yes, yes. So those are the points for today's Habit of Health or Healthy Habit Facebook Live for Musings with Lauren. I'm Lauren. We all know that at this point. So planning and consistency, using your past as a university, and then giving yourself grace. So those are the things about not being able to cheat the grind. Thank you. Thank you so much, Sora. I appreciate it, Sans. And then, you know, those other things along the way, insights when the path to your journey takes an unexpected turn. So we cover those as well. So thank you guys so much for watching. I want to wish you an amazing rest of your Thursday, and we'll see you next Thursday for our Healthy Habit Facebook Live, Musings with Lauren. Bye for now.